else I've heard that the Blessed One was staying at Savatthi, residing at the Jeta's grove in Anathapinda's park. Then in the dark of the night, a radiant deva illuminated old Jeta's grove. She bowed down low before the Blessed One, then standing to one side, she said, "Devas are concerned for happiness and ever long for peace. Same is true of humankind. What then are the highest blessings? Avoiding those of foolish ways, associating with the wise, and honoring those worthy of honor. These are the highest blessings. Living in places of suitable kinds with the fruits of past good deeds, guided by the rightful way. These are the highest blessings. Accomplished in learning and craftsman skill, with discipline highly trained, and speech that is true, pleasant to hear, these are the highest blessings. Fighting for mother and father's support, and cherishing family, ways of work harm no beings, these are the highest. Giving with Dharma in the heart, offering help to relatives and kin, and acting in ways that leave no blame, these are the highest blessings. Steadfast in restraint and shunning evil ways, and avoiding intoxicants that dull the mind, and hearing the Dharma frequently taught, these are the highest blessings. Patience and willingness to accept one's faults, seeing venerated seekers of the truth, sharing often the words of Dharma, these are the highest blessings. Life lived without an effort, seeing for oneself the noble truths, the realization of Nibbana, these are the highest blessings. Although involved with worldly ways and shaken, the mind remains, and beyond all sorrow, spotless, secure, these are the highest blessings. They who live by following this path know victory wherever they go, and every place for them is safe. These are the highest blessings.